Hey guys, Scott here again from Scott's Bass Lessons. Hope you're well. Today I'm going to be talking about dynamics. Now, this is something that when I watch a lot of bass players and a lot of students coming to me, this is a real big flaw. They haven't got particularly good dynamics. And looking into my past, I definitely suffered with this as well. In fact, there was a particular occasion when I was working upon a cruise ship when I was, I think I was about 20 year old, 21. I just started working as a professional musician. And the musical director pulled me aside after a couple of weeks and said, "Scott, you've got an issue with your dynamics." And I said, "An issue with my dynamics?" And he said, yeah, an issue with them. And I said, "What's the issue?" And he said, "The issue is that you haven't got any dynamics. You just play one level all the time. Monotonal." And just like if you've ever, you know, had the unfortunate conversation with somebody who speaks in a monotonal voice like this all the time and doesn't happen to say anything particularly interesting, okay, it just zones you out, doesn't it? And it's exactly the same with bass playing, or not only bass playing, you know, everything, every instrument, and not only instruments, talking as well. You need dynamics to express, you know, what needs to be expressed within the music that you're playing. So I'm going to show you an exercise at the end of this video, but first of all, I just want to talk about dynamics on the bass, okay? And particularly, I'm talking about just going up and down in volume and different tones you can get from the bass as well. Like, for instance, just by moving your hand along here, you can get different dynamics from the bass, okay? If I put everything up full on the bass, if I play around, say, the centre here, so sort of like kind of in between the neck and the bridge, I'm going to get a nice overall, you know, quite neutral tone. Okay, whereas if I play it back towards the bridge, it's more of a punchy tone. Hear the difference? And again, if I play over here, over the neck, completely different tone again. So you can use your right hand to create different dynamics. Okay, now this is just right hand placement. So this is just placement of the right hand creating dynamics. Obviously you can use different, what's the word? You can play the string harder or softer, but I'm not talking about that right now. All I'm talking about right now is playing in different positions, using that to alter your dynamics, okay? So back by the bridge, in the center, and by the neck. Three completely different tones. And obviously there's varying degrees in between them as well, but they're the three main ones, okay? So if it was a walking bass line, you'd probably play it over the neck to get that rounded tone, okay? Get that, you know, that upright kind of thing, instead of down there. That'll give you a more modern tone, more punchy, and cut through the mix more. So again, it depends on what the instrumentation of the band is like as well, and what the actual the musical director or the guy who's running the band, what he wants. Well, you've got to take that into consideration. So, you know, think about it. When you're playing, are you playing monotonely? Are you taking this into consideration? Because you should be. It's something I try and do all the time, especially when I was told off. So experiment with that. Now, the exercise I'm going to give you isn't really dealing with this. It's dealing with altering how hard you attack the string, because that's the next stage of dynamics you should be looking into. So if you take a simple major scale, I'm going to take an F major scale, okay? So and when I'm looping major scales, I like to actually put the major 7 in the bottom as well, okay? So it makes it nice and even, so you get. And okay, it makes it into a 4-4 time signature. So that's the pattern we're going to use. My phone making bad noises. My dad. There you go. There's my dad. So that's the pattern for the exercise. Now what I want you to do is I want you to play one loop round, so up the scale ascending, then descending, and I want you to play as quiet as possible. So when you're playing this quiet as possible, what I want you to be aware of is not to slow down. Okay, see, you can try it with a metronome if you want, but just make sure you don't slow down, because people, when they first try and do this, when they're trying to alter the dynamics of their right hand, they tend to, when they play quietly, slow down, and when they play loud, they speed up. Okay, so play as quietly as you can, just round that little loop I showed you. Okay, so here we go. Actually, I'm going to slow it down a bit for you guys. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now I'm going to play normally. Notice that the tempo is even though I'm playing a little bit louder. So I'm doing 4 of each. Now I'm going to dig in. Okay, so I'm just going to play one loop of each. So I'm going to go quiet, medium, loud, medium, quiet. Okay? Now let's speed it up, okay? So, you don't have to speed up if you don't want, but I'm going to speed up anyway. So, quiet. Medium. Now let's just do one of each. Quiet, medium, hard, medium, quiet. See how the volume, the consistency of the notes, the speed stays the same, but it's just the dynamics of the hand that change, okay? Now I'm doing it around a whole loop of a major scale. You don't have to do that, you could do it per string, okay? So, I'm going to start quiet. By the time I get down to the G string, I'm going to be digging in. And by the time I get back down to the A string, I'm going to be playing quiet again. So, really slowly, it will go like this. Fast, it'll sound like this. And that's how I get that. And you can use that, you can fluctuate it. Once you can do this and you've got the muscle memory or the program that you need to your brain needs to send to your hands to tell you how to do this, once that's there, you can then fluctuate, okay? So for instance, just like I did there, so And I'm just doing that with my right hand, but it's these little exercises where you take one string quiet, one string medium, one string loud, and then move it back and forth, and really be strict when you're doing it. It's doing that that will give you the facility to be able to... to do it faster like that. So hopefully you enjoyed this lesson. I'm hoping that you get your bass out and try some of this stuff on your own, in your own time. Remember to like this lesson just underneath down there, and share it with as many people as possible. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do that. And more importantly, subscribe to my website, scottsbasslessons.com, and I'll send you some free exclusive subscriber only content and other goodies too. So I'll see you soon and get in the shed. Take it easy.